Welcome to Bedford View Methodist Church. We would like to share some dates with you as we enter the Advent season this year. There will be a baptism at the 9:30 service on the 5th of December. Please book your seat through our office for this service. In the evening, there is a Carols by Candlelight picnic from 6 p.m. As of the 19th of December, there will be only one service on Sundays. These family services will happen at 9:30. On the 24th of December, there is a Christmas Eve service at 6 o'clock. Christmas Day will see us meeting at 7:30 and 9:30. It is important to remember to book for these services. There will be a Thanksgiving service at 9:30 on the 26th. And on the last day of 2021, we will meet for a Watch Night service at 6 o'clock. Enjoy the service.
Good morning, BMC family. Welcome to our worship service this morning. I hope that you are all well wherever you are watching this service from. Friends, today is our first Sunday of the Advent season. And our Advent theme for this year, 2021, is the Messiah is coming. And so we celebrate this coming weeks and we anticipate the coming of the Messiah. And so friends, as we draw our minds and our thoughts together, as we anticipate the coming of the Messiah, let us find our call to worship as it is recorded in the book of Isaiah chapter 49. We will read verses 8 until verse 9. This is what the Lord says. In the time of my favor, I will answer you. And in the day of salvation, I will help you. I will keep you and I will make you to be a covenant for the people, to restore the land, to reassign its desolate inheritance, to say to the captives, come out, and to those in darkness, be free. And so indeed, as we anticipate the coming of Christ, we are reminded that there will be a time where we will be told that indeed we are free. And so the birth of Christ represents us being free from the captive of sin. And so friends, this moment we take time to light the peace candle. And this moment also we light our first candle of the Advent season, which represents peace. And so friends, let us pray. And so mighty and loving God, as we light these candles, may they shine in the world. May they represent the peace that is found in you. May those, O God, who are seeing the flames that come from these candles, see the light in their lives, see the light in their families, see the light in the country and the community they find themselves in. May the peace, O God, that is found in you, reign in our lives and in our families. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Friends, join me as we sing our opening song together. Stand, let us sing.
All who are thirsty, fountain, dip your heart in the stream of life. Let the pain and the sorrow be washed away in the waves of His mercy, as deep cries out to deep, we sing, come Lord. Jesus, come. Come, Lord Jesus, come. Come, Lord Jesus, come. Come, Lord Jesus, come. All who are thirsty, to the fountain, dip your heart in the stream of life, let the pain and the sorrow be washed away in the waves of His mercy, as deep cries out to deep, we sing, come Lord. Jesus, come. Come, Lord Jesus, come. Come, Lord Jesus, come. Come, Lord Jesus.
Amen. Friends, let us continue with our prayers. Come, let us pray. Gracious and loving God, we come before you, acknowledging, O God, that indeed you are great, you are merciful, you are loving, you are powerful. And that is why, O God, it is not through our will or our strength that we are still here this morning. But it is through your grace and your mercy, O God, that has seen us through the beginning of this week until now. It is only through your mercy, O God, that we are able to be seated where we are. We are joined by our families, by those whom we love the most at this time, as we bring our praise and our worships to you. We acknowledge, O God, that you and you alone are our God and our King. And so we bring praise, we bring honor, we bring worship to you. And so accept, O God, our humble attempts of honoring and praising you this morning. And so be with us, O God, be with each and every one of us, those who are gathered here in the sanctuary and those who are watching online. May you bless us, Almighty God, in this time where we dwell in your presence, in your mercy, hear our prayers. Almighty God, we come acknowledging our faults. We come acknowledging our limits. We come acknowledging, O God, that we have not been truthful. We have done the things that we are not supposed to do. We have made a mockery of your name. We have made a mockery of your call. And yet, O God, we are reassured that if we come sincerely and we confess our sins to you, you are a God that hears us. You are a God that forgives. And so we bring our hearts, O God, that have done the things that we are not supposed to do. We bring our hearts, O God, that have done wrong to those who we live with, who we share life with. We bring our hearts, O God, that have wronged you as our King and God. Forgive us, O God, for the sins we have done intentionally and unintentionally. We rejoice knowing, O God, that before we even utter our sins to you, you are a God that forgives. And so we come to say thank you, O God, for the forgiveness of our sins. Thank you for a God that loves and a God that forgives. In your mercy, hear our prayers. Almighty God, I bring this morning those who are in desperate need of your love and your touch this morning. I bring those, O God, who aren't able to pray for themselves, who find it difficult to go on their knees this morning and have a conversation with you. I pray for those, O God, who find themselves in hospital beds, who are fighting for their lives. I pray, O God, for those who find themselves in jail cells, who have regretted the things that have made them land in the places that they are at the moment. I pray, O God, for those whom have lost everything, have lost their jobs, have lost their homes, have lost their children, have lost their parents. Those, O God, who are yearning for your touch, who are yearning for your hug, who are yearning for your comfort. Be with them, Almighty God, this morning. May you reveal yourself in their lives. May they know that you, O God, never leaves them nor forsakes them. That you're a God that helps them throughout their times of need. And that all they need to do is call upon your name, and you, O God, will reveal yourself in their lives. And so we pray for them. We intercede on their behalf this morning. We pray, O God, that you will not only listen to our mouths, because at times words fail to express what is in our hearts. And so we ask that you listen also to our hearts, to the deep meditations of our hearts, that you will hear, O God, our aches and our pains, our sufferings, our disbelief, our loss of hope, that you will give us wisdom and strength, O God, to be able to get through the pains and the troubles that we are facing at the moment. In your mercy, hear our prayers. Friends, mighty God, I bring this morning your church, not only the church BMC, but the church universal. I pray for its leaders. I pray for its congregation, that they remain truthful to you and the call that you have bestowed on them. May they be the light of the world, O God. May they confess nothing but the truths about you. May the world come to know through your church what it means to have a loving God such as you. And so bless us, O God, as your flock. We anticipate, O God, the coming of our Messiah. And so, like the apostles who were gathered for the Holy Spirit in one roof, in one voice, we pray, O God, that you will shower us this morning with your Spirit, that we will be drunkard by your Holy Spirit, so that we truly can go into the world and reveal to the world the God whom we love and we worship. We ask all of these things in the wonderful name of Jesus Christ, who together with you and the Holy Spirit reigns as one true God. Amen.
Luke 21, verses 25 to 36. There will be signs in the sun, moon, and stars. On the earth, nations will be in anguish and perplexity at the roaring and tossing of the sea. People will faint from terror, apprehensive of what is coming on the world, for the heavenly bodies will be shaken. At that time they will see the Son of Man coming in a cloud with power and great glory. When these things begin to take place, stand up and lift up your heads, because your redemption is drawing near. He told them this parable. Look at the fig tree and all the trees. When they sprout leaves, you can see for yourselves and know that summer is near. Even so, when you see these things happening, you know that the kingdom of God is near. Truly I tell you, this generation will certainly not pass away until all these things have happened. Heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will never pass away. Be careful, or your hearts will be weighed down with carousing, drunkenness, and the anxieties of life, and that day will close on you suddenly like a trap. For it will come on all those who live on the face of the whole earth. Be always on the watch, and pray that you may be able to escape all that is about to happen, and that you may be able to stand before the Son of Man.
Let us pray. Glorious and mighty God, we thank you for this time. We thank you for this moment. May you speak through me, O God, for your children, your servants are waiting for a word of encouragement, comfort, aspiration, and hope from you. And so may you use me just as a vessel, O God, that spreads nothing but the good news about you. And so be with us. In Jesus' mighty name I pray. Amen. So friends, may I take this opportunity once again to greet you all in the wonderful name of my personal Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. So friends, as I have mentioned at the beginning, that our theme for this Advent season is the Messiah is coming. And our sub-theme for this Sunday is your redemption is drawing near. We read from the Gospel according to St. Luke chapter 21 verses 25 to 38. It is in this passage where we hear and we see Jesus teaching to his disciples. Luke records this and prepares us for the second coming of the Messiah who comes to redeem us. Now, the word redemption in the Greek language is apotrolosis, which refers to the deliverance of Christians from sin. And so the coming of Jesus is about being delivered and freed from the bondage and captivity of sin. And so friends, this Advent season, as we kick it off, when we think and we celebrate and reflect on what it means for the Messiah to come, may we remember that the coming of the Messiah represents our redemption drawing near. And our redemption drawing near refers to us being freed from sin, us being taken away from being captives and slaves of sin. And so friends, redemption, if you speak to other authors, if you speak to other scholars, biblical scholars, when they speak about redemption, the word redemption is attached to the connotation of a second chance or rebirth. And so the redemption being drawn, or rather our redemption drawing nearer, refers to us being born anew, us getting a second chance. And we get a second chance because our Messiah came, and our Messiah is coming to save us from ourselves, to move us away from sin. And so that's what it means when we speak about our redemption is drawing near. And so friends, there are two points that I want us to look at this morning. The first point that I want us to look at is the signs of our redemption drawing near. And the second point that I want us to look at is, what is our response to our redemption drawing nearer? Friends, it is important as you read in verse 25 and 26, and may I read it? It says, there will be signs in the sun, moon, and stars. On the earth, nations will be in anguish, perplexity at the roaring of the sea. People will faint from terror, apprehensive of what is coming on the world, for their heavenly bodies will be shaken. And this, Luke says, are the signs of our redemption drawing nearer. These are the signs of our God, Jesus Christ, coming down to us. So friends, when the world sees these signs, they seem as if the world is coming to an end. When people notice these signs, we have two kinds of people. Those who believe in a coming Messiah, who view these signs as signs of a Christ that is coming to redeem us. And then there are those who do not believe in our Messiah, who view these signs as the end of the world or as an end of times, the apocalypse. But friends, I want us, as we reflect and discern this morning, to realize that when people who do not believe in your Messiah see the signs of a Messiah coming down, they would think that the world is coming to an end. But I come to tell you, view these signs as signs of a Messiah coming to redeem you. For your redemption is drawing nearer. And so, friends, it is significant to understand that both those who do not believe and those who believe view the same Messiah, view the same signs, rather. For God, our God, does not only come for those who believe, but Christ comes for everyone. Salvation is for everyone. And so those who do not believe will still be able to see the signs of the coming Messiah. And I want you to hear me. I want you to hear me well. Your redemption is drawing near. Your redemption is not yet here. And so there is still chance for you and I to repent. We still have a chance to go towards Christ and to go and accept Christ and receive our redemption. All we have to do is to see the signs that our Messiah is coming, that our redemption is drawing nearer. Friends, why is it so significant to then refer to our redemption coming nearer? Remember, I said that redemption is given a connotation of a second chance or a rebirth. And so what does the Messiah coming mean to you and I? The coming of the Messiah means that we have an opportunity to begin to become new people. Remember, Paul writes and says, Christ lives in me, and I'm born anew because Christ now lives in me. Right? And so when Christ lives in you, you become anew. You are born anew. And so the redemption, or rather the coming of the Messiah, is an opportunity for you and I to turn our backs from sin, to move away from sin, and to follow Christ. That's what redemption means. And that's why we anticipate, we rejoice when we come together in this Advent season as we remember, ponder, and reflect and celebrate that the Messiah is coming. So remember, friends, that the Messiah is coming to redeem you. The Messiah is coming to save you. Isn't it in Exodus where we read the story of Moses and God speaking, where God says to Moses, I have heard the cries of my people, and therefore me as God, I have come down to rescue them. And so it is not foreign for God to come. It is not foreign for the Messiah to come, because it is in the nature of the God that we serve for him to come and redeem us. It is in the nature of Christ to come and save us particularly from ourselves. And so I want you to know this morning that redemption means you getting a second chance. I do not know where your relationship with God is at the moment, but I come to remind you that time is quickly running out. Fix your relationship with Christ now, for the Messiah is coming and your redemption is drawing nearer. Now, I want you to understand this. Signs are important because it is through signs that we prepare ourselves for what is about to happen. It is through signs where we get to be able to constantly be on the outlook or by looking at the opportunity of us receiving our redemption from Christ. And so there might be someone here who is watching the service this morning who does not understand where they stand with God, who yet have a relationship with Christ, and who is looking for a sign that Christ exists. And I come to tell you that when things seem to be coming to an end, when things seem to be dark, that's when you realize that the Messiah is coming. I want to put this quickly so that you understand. In the book of Genesis, we read that God created everything. And so when the Messiah comes, all that God has created will respond to what God has created. Rather, let me say that again. When God through Christ comes, everything that God created will respond to the coming of the Messiah. So do not be alarmed when you think that things are falling apart and the world is coming to an end. Remember that the world for you and I will not come to an end until our Messiah is here. So these are mere signs. These are mere signs of a Messiah that is coming. So hold on, for your redemption is drawing near. Friends, my second point this morning, and then I'm done. My second point is, what is our response to our redemption drawing nearer? Listen to verse 27 and verse 28. We are told that at that time, they will see the Son of Man coming on a cloud with power and great glory. When these things begin to take place, stand up. Lift up your heads, because your redemption is drawing near. And so, friends, I want to tell you this morning, that when the Messiah comes, when you notice these things, when you notice the Messiah coming down, Luke tells us that you must be ready.
You must be responding to the coming of the Messiah. And so there are two things that I want to propose to you this morning about standing and being ready for the coming of the Messiah. There are two things that I expected of you. The first thing that you must do is to repent from your sin. In order to receive your redemption from Christ, in order to receive your second chance from Christ, you must be willing to turn your back on your old life. You must be willing to repent from the sins that you have done intentionally and non-intentionally. That is what is required of us. When you read the ministry of John the Baptist, John the Baptist only preached one sermon, and that sermon was repent, for the kingdom of God is drawing near. And so I come like John the Baptist this morning to remind you that it is now time to repent, because the Messiah is coming. Your redemption is drawing near. And in order to receive your blessings, in order to receive your redemption, you then need to frown upon the sins and to frown upon the old life that you lived. My second point under what is our response to our redemption drawing nearer is, when you have repented from your sins, you then accept Christ as your personal Lord and Savior. Friends, the Messiah is your Lord. The Messiah is your Savior. The Messiah is your God. And so when we see him coming, when we anticipate his coming, we not only repent, but we also accept him as our Lord and Savior. That is all that is required from us. There are two things that will make us be able to receive our redemption from Christ. And that is to repent from our sins and to accept Christ as our Lord and Savior. Because friends, once you have accepted Christ, once you acknowledge Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, things in your life will change. You will be one who is now united with Christ. You will be one who is one with Christ. You will be able to access and inherit the kingdom of God. And so when the apocalypse, when they think it is an apocalypse, and when they think the world is coming to an end, you are then telling them, and you will tell them, but no, this is a time where I am readying myself to receive Christ, to accept Christ, and to inherit the kingdom of God. And that is what it means, friends, for us to accept, or what that is our response to our redemption of a Christ that comes to us, a Messiah that comes, who gives us redemption, who redeems us. And so what is then, friends, our duty when we have heard that the Messiah is coming, when we have heard that our redemption is drawing nearer? We repent, we accept Christ, and then after, as I conclude, we go into the world and we go tell the world that time has come to come nearer to Christ, because Christ is coming. And when Christ comes, he comes to take those who are his, those who belong to him, because he has made a room ready for us in heaven. And so in order for us to access heaven, we need to accept the redemption that is found in Christ. And so I hope, friends, that this week will be a week in which you frown upon your sins, you move away from your sins, and you accept Christ as your personal Lord and Savior. And then you identify and notice the signs that are out there of a Christ who is coming to save you. In Jesus' name, I pray. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty and living God, we thank you. We thank you for your word. We thank you for your message this morning. May you be with us, O God, as we reflect and ponder upon this message. May we be moved. May we be uplifted, and may we be challenged by your word this morning. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray. Amen. Friends, as we close off the service, let us stand and sing our closing song together.
To the river I am going, bringing sins I cannot bear. Come and cleanse me, come forgive me, Lord, I need to meet you there. Precious Jesus, I am ready to surrender every care. Take my hand now, lead me closer, Lord, I need to meet you there. In these waters, healing mercy flows with freedom from despair. I am going to that river, Lord, I need to meet you there. Precious Jesus, I am ready to surrender every care. Take my hand now, lead me closer, Lord, I need to meet you there. Come and join us in the river. Come find life beyond compare. He is calling, he is waiting. Jesus longs to meet us all there. Precious Jesus, I am ready to surrender every care. Take my hand now, lead me closer, Lord, I need to meet you
Amen. May we rise as we say the benediction. Now may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all, now and forevermore. Amen. See you guys soon as we see you. God bless you. Bye.